Sana Khan and you're watching MediCircle. Today we have with us on our doctor's speak a homeopathic doctor, a counselor, a technology enthusiast. He has 10 years of experience in homeopathy and has worked with 1MG and MediAngels. Also, he is the founder of Life Plus Homeopathy Clinic in Mumbai. Please welcome with us Dr. Ankit Soni to our show. Hi, Dr. Ankit, how are you?
Hi, thank you. Thank you, Sana, for such a sweet introduction, actually. I'm really, really glad to be on the show. And actually, I just want to commend you and your team for doing excellent work in providing a lot of insights on healthcare, and especially in the current scenario of pandemic, where a lot of falsehood is easier to spread.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you very much. Okay. Homeopathy has been an old field of medicine, and we all know the no side effects benefit of it. But do you think in India, people don't have much belief in the process? What could be the reason?
According to me, I guess it's otherwise, especially in case of India. There has been a lot of awareness in India about the treatment. So if we talk from the highest level, Indian government promotes homeopathy a lot. There is a dedicated ministry for homeopathy, which is Ayush Ministry, which is now quite well known than earlier. Yes. Especially homeopathy in last 50 years has grown a lot. It is probably the second most preferred treatment modality after modern medicine. Yes. And yes, for a lot of us, that's the first or rather the most preferred choice of treatment. So yes, homeopathy is gaining a lot of recognition, especially in the last 50 years. As far as patients are concerned, yes, patients also have a lot of belief in the whole process of treatment. We, especially at Life Plus, have touched at least probably about 30,000 plus lives in the last 10 years. And we have been able to make a lot of difference in the lives.
You're a technology enthusiast, and this is a digital age. Also, the pandemic has raised a lot of awareness about the pros of using tech in healthcare. What do you Right. think the future of medicine will be like?
I guess telemedicine is here to stay. I was associated with MediAngels initially, where I came to know about telemedicine and understand it, the nitty-gritties of it. So probably MediAngels was slightly earlier than their age. So it was they're kind of very few, one of the very few industries or companies or startups rather to promote telemedicine. So telemedicine definitely is the medicine of future. There is a lot of disparity in the healthcare delivery system, especially metros and tier one cities have a good access of medical healthcare. But tier two, tier three cities, especially rural India, where majority of our population is, the availability of specialist doctors is very, very sparse. Even the primary healthcare centers are not very great there. So telemedicine is the way to to bridge this gap or disparity of unavailability of specialist healthcare. So if I give you an example of my own clinic, we had certain protocols of telemedicine going on since a very long time before this pandemic actually happened. So we were catering to our overseas patients through video conferencing. And so that those things were already going on. And in this pandemic also, because we had already said certain things, how we'll be going about. So even if there was a complete lockdown in the country, we were able to cater to all our patients. There was no problem, no lag in the delivery of healthcare. We used to send the medicines on the same day. So yes, I guess telemedicine is now slightly becoming mainstream, and it will not replace the traditional medicine, but yes, telemedicine is here to stay.
You have a very interesting experience background with working with MediAngels, 1MG, and now with Life Plus. How has your journey been?
Well, journey has been superb. There was a lot of growth in me that I've seen from starting my clinic just after passing out, just with the aim of providing quality homeopathic treatment. And from there, I actually came in association with MediAngels, where I understood things about second opinion services, telemedicine. And eventually I came in association with OneMD, which was providing an end-to-end solution kind of a stuff. So that learning helped me a lot to implement those things in my own clinic. And yes, because of this whole journey or because of this whole experience, a personal growth definitely did happen. Also, I was able to implement a lot of things in my own clinic and was able to make a lot of difference to my patients.
We have heard a lot of claims of getting a cure for the coronavirus, one of which was from the homeopathic field. What do you think, is there actually a homeopathy medicine for coronavirus?
So, there's no straight answer to this, but I'll try and explain as much as possible. Okay. So what we have to understand is that treatment, there are two parts in treatment. One is preventive treatment and one is curative treatment. So let us understand slightly about curative and preventive treatment, right? So in case of preventive treatment, as the word suggests, we try and prevent the disease happening in a healthy individual. And in case of curative treatment, we try to make the patient recover from the from the disease that that patient is already having. Mm-hmm. So in case of homeopathy, the last pandemic that world now knows, because it was all there in the history books, but nobody knew about the Spanish flu that happened at the fag end of the World War I, around 1918. So in that scenario, homeopathy did make a lot of difference. At that time, modern medicine was not that advanced that it is right now. So in those days, what happened is that a lot of homeopaths, we already had a principle in homeopathy that is called as genus epidemicus. So what we do is that we try to collect symptoms of a particular community and we try and find a single remedy or a single medicine that might have helped, that might help treat those patients. So what our pioneers did at that time was they collected symptoms from a particular community and then they employed that medicine within that community. And the observation that was there is that people who were administered these medicines, the incidence of Spanish flu or the disease at that time was much, much, much lower than the overall incidence, the rate of incidence in that country or in that region. Mm-hmm. So yes, that was the experience that we already had. In the current scenario, again, our central research council, that is CCRH, that is Central Council of Research in Homeopathy, which is the ICMR equivalent for homeopathy. Okay. So that this institute did some research and they suggested Arsenicum album as the possible genus epidemicus, which our government, the Ayush Ministry, did promote. And in our clinic also, we did employ a lot of this medicine to our own patient. And my personal observation was that to all the patients that we gave arsenic, none of them have been contracted with corona. So that is the preventive part of it. Yes, so for preventive, of course, you have to follow the other norms, that is social distancing, wearing of mask, hand sanitization, washing of hands. All those things are definitely required. But an additional layer of protection definitely can be provided by homeopathy in the form of preventive. Talking about curative treatment, which is what everybody is interested in, rather. So in case of curative treatment, how homeopathy works, we have to understand is that homeopathy is an individualized science of treatment. So in case of modern medicine, let's say 100 patients come to us with fever. So we'll give them paracetamol, and most of them, not all, but most of them, their fever will be absolutely under control. But in case of a patient coming to us with fever and we're trying to treat them with homeopathy, those 100 patients might require 100 different medicines. So it is very, very highly individualized method of treatment. Mm-hmm. So having said that, if in current scenario, we want to give treatment to the patient who is having corona or COVID-19, we'll have to take symptom totality of that patient. Also, So in current scenario, what can happen, with all the treatment modalities in place of the modern medicine, homeopathy can definitely be offered in the form of a complementary or supplementary modality of treatment. So yes, it can work hand in hand and in a synergistic way, probably help the patient. But the thing that is very important is that the symptom totality has to be taken from that patient. If that is the case, absolutely homeopathy can be helped. But if you want to know if a single medicine will be able to help, no, by principle, homeopathy cannot be employed in the form of one size fit all kind of a situation. So that is not possible. So hence, a single remedy is not possible. But yes, if symptom totality is present, homeopathy can definitely be a very important complementary or supplementary mode of treatment.
Thank you so much, Dr. Ankit, for giving us your insights on homeopathy. It was great talking to you, and it was a pleasure having you on our MediCircle platform. Thank you so
Absolutely.
Much.
Absolutely. Pleasure is all mine. Pleasure is all mine, Sana. Thank you. Thank you so much for having me on this show.
Thank you, sir.